Boundary and Annexation Survey, or BAS Partnership Toolbox 2, Reviewing and Updating Boundaries. This video will cover submission guidelines for digital BAS participants and demonstrate how to use the Create Changes, Sliver Blaster, and Format Working MXD tools within the BAS Partnership Toolbox to update legal boundaries and format a working map file. Through BAS, participants have the ability to record legal changes such as annexations, deannexations, incorporations, and disincorporations, as well as boundary corrections. Linear features and point and area landmarks are also available for updates. This video series focuses on using the BAS Partnership Toolbox to make legal boundary updates. Currently, the BAS Partnership Toolbox is not able to create linear feature, area, or point landmark updates. For guidance on how to create these changes outside of the BAS Partnership Toolbox, refer to Chapter 5, Sections 5.4 and 5.5 in the Digital BAS Respondent Guide. For all reported legal changes, including annexations, deannexations, incorporations, and disincorporations, the user must provide legal boundary change information, such as the change type, authorization type, documentation numbers, the effective date of the change, and area in acres, if available. Boundary corrections are adjustments to inaccurate boundaries due to spatial misalignments. These types of changes do not require any documentation. As part of their BAS submission, participants are able to use the BAS Partnership Toolbox to create and submit change polygons. Change polygons represent the difference between a local government's boundary data and the U.S. Census Bureau's boundary data. For example, if a government annexed a large amount of land and wishes to report the annexation through BAS, they are able to use the toolbox to create the change polygons they want to submit to BAS. In this example, the change polygons shown in red represent what the Census Bureau receives through BAS. The Create Changes tool in the BAS Partnership Toolbox provides users with the functionality to create change polygons. Before using this tool, users should ensure there is an attribute field in the user's local boundary layer that contains the name of the government or governments that match how they appear in Census Bureau records. This includes capitalization, spacing, and in the case of minor civil divisions, or MCDs, a descriptor of the geography. Once the local boundary layer is formatted correctly, double-click the Create Changes tool. The Create Changes window opens. In the Local Boundary File field, enter the path to or navigate to the location of the local boundary layer. In the BAS ID field, enter the 11-digit BAS ID. In the Changes Being Processed field, choose the type of changes to create from the drop-down menu. In the Name field in Local Data field, type the name of the field containing the information matching the Census Bureau's name field as it appears in ART Catalog. If processing an MCD or American Indian Alaska Native Native Hawaiian file where the Census Bureau name field contains duplicates, match the name in the Census Bureau's name LSAD field. Select OK to run the tool. Once the tool finishes, the user will find the output file within the GeoDatabase under the Submission Feature dataset. Repeat these steps for any other levels of geography that need changes created. After running the Create Changes tool, some users may find they have numerous small change polygons that are time-consuming to manually review. Since the Census Bureau cannot guarantee inclusion of changes under 30 feet unless housing and population is impacted, use the optional Sliver Blaster tool to remove changes that are lower than that threshold. Begin by double-clicking the Sliver Blaster tool. The Sliver Blaster tool window opens. In the Changes File field, navigate to the file created using the Create Changes tool. In the Census Edges field, navigate to the BAS Edges feature class within the reference dataset. The buffer distance field is set to 30 feet by default, but users are able to adjust this value to accommodate smaller changes if they know there are small changes that need to be included. Once the fields are populated and the buffer distance feet is set to the appropriate value, select OK to run the tool. This tool deletes all change polygons that are lower than the provided threshold. At this point, the user should review the change file or files for required attribution and spatial accuracy. The BAS Partnership Toolbox provides the Format Working MXD tool to assist users in creating a map document containing their change file and all the reference layers they need to review their changes. If users prefer to create and use their own MXD, this tool is not required. Begin by double-clicking the Format Working MXD tool. The Format Working MXD window opens. The only input for this tool is the working folder, which is the folder nested under the Projects folder that contains the government's BAS ID. Select OK to run the tool. This tool creates an MXD named after the government's BAS ID. Users who do not see the map document show up after running the tool should refresh their Projects folder. Users may open the new MXD file and begin working with the change polygons. For assistance creating a digital BAS submission, refer to the Digital Respondent Guide, which is available on the BAS website. Chapter 5 includes information about making updates to the Census Bureau shapefiles. The Partnership Toolbox Overview document, included with the toolbox download, contains information regarding the Create Changes, Sliver Blaster, and Format Working MXD tools. For BAS support, please contact the Census Bureau by phone toll-free at 1-800-972-5651 or by email at geo.bas@census.gov. Participants may also refer to the BAS website for resources.